Alice in Wonderland is my favorite book. I quote it endlessly, mainly because we can learn a lot from Alice. What a fearless chick, eating and drinking whatever is at hand, growing tall, growing small, and always, always trying to find a way out of that rabbit hole that she fell into. One of my favorites is hear what the Red Queen tells Alice. Now, here you see, it takes all the running you can do to keep in the same place. If you look at it, most of us are doing the same thing. We run and we run and we run, and it seems like we are in the same place. It's great when you're on a treadmill, but not so much in work and life. And that is the focus of this episode. How to become productive so that the needle actually moves. Hi, I'm Sheila, and this is Lumiere 24. Light on! Our life is an endless stream of incoming information and things to do. More and more of us are addicted to our smartphones and our social media in the hope of being ahead in the race. Here's the bad news. You will never manage to stay ahead. And the good news? You really don't need to. So here's the first tip for more productivity. A laser-sharp focus will ensure that you use your time well, whether you're a big cog in the corporate world, or a startup, or a stay-at-home mom or dad. A streamlined focus is your number one distraction detractor. To decide what information you remain open to and what tasks you take on, you have to be clear on what you want to do. Clarity is power. By developing a map in advance to guide your energy, time, focus, your frequency, and your budget, you will be able to say yes to certain uses of your time much more easily and no to others that fall outside the perimeter of your target area. For example, if you know that the best way to create clients is by bringing them to your website, then you can create those offers instead of getting sucked into long hours of social media posting that gets you no clear results. You don't have to do everything yourself. Create your circle of affordable resources for that which distracts you from your focus. There are plenty of fabulous and affordable virtual assistants, logo designers, web designers who can do what you're trying to do better, more efficiently, and will help you keep your focus. And the money you spend will be doubled in the time and energy you retain. Explore what amount of hours and sleep really work best for you. Find out just what are your most creative and productive times and schedule your work with that in mind. Schedule time for writing just as you would a client. If you know that it's difficult to have a few focused hours for completing an important project, like writing a newsletter, creating a video, whatever, then turn your phone off during that period. While working at your computer, turn off all your email or incoming post sounds. This may seem like a small distraction, but 20 to 100 beeps per day keeps you in erratic, unfocused state that can easily divert your attention and break your focus. The moment you realize you have to do something that captures your attention, like when you receive an email that you have to act upon right away, if it will take you less than 2 minutes, go ahead and do it. If you honestly know that it will take you more than 2 minutes, schedule completing it at a later time. Brian Tracy explains this so beautifully in his book. Figure out what tasks you're putting off and do it first. Get the ugliest, slimiest job out of your way by tackling it first. Remember to take mini breaks at least every hour or so. Support yourself in scheduling a 15-minute maxi break at least every 2 hours to step outside, stretch, sit on your gym ball, get up to get a snack, whatever. Taking short breaks help productivity. Breaks prevent you from becoming fatigued and tired, and they help you slow down, step back from your work, reflect, and come up with better ideas. Before you begin your workday, make a list of 3 outcomes you wish to have occur by the end of the day. Not to-do items, outcomes. This is a terrific and easy to implement productivity ritual. Define three results or outcomes that you want to have happen today. These are results that you want to get done. Find one activity that gives you more energy and schedule it, whether it's a run, a walk on the beach, playing with your dog, catching some sunshine, blasting some music, dancing, snuggling, whatever. These life-giving activities are nourishing and need to be as important to your schedule as your appointments and work tasks. So go ahead, schedule them now. These 10 tips should get you started if you're feeling buried under that mountain of distractions. Let me know how it works out for you. You can use these tips to build your business or set up a new one or to merely oil your household wheels. Share this video with your family and friends. Come on, spread the light, folks. We all deserve a better world.